So we have the pedestrian crosswalk here striped with white. We have a green striped bike crossing. We have the corner islands, and then out in the center line, we have the left turn hardening that's been installed.
This is where the predominance of our pedestrian traffic was.
We have responded for years to crashes and to pedestrians injured along this road and in this intersection.
We picked this location because of its proximity to major employment centers, residential housing that was being redeveloped at the time, and of course the transit center.
One of the main factors that this intersection does for pedestrians is it reduces the exposure. The distance between the curbs is the same for pedestrians as it was before, but the corner islands reduce the amount of time that they're exposed to drivers. You used to have to cross about 52 feet curb to curb here. Now you're only exposed to drivers for about 22 feet. But the other thing it does is it slows down those drivers.
The partnership between the state and the local county here is crucial to being able to have a comprehensive, holistic approach to making pedestrian and bicycle safety improvements that we need here.
I'm the design lead for the project, so I took the project from planning to design to construction.
It's important for us to do outreach in the community.
You have to be intentional and care and really work with and be there with these communities.
So not only do I service a certain area as a volunteer medic, but I'm a pedestrian in that same area. So I know a lot of these intersections. I know sometimes that the lights are slow. You want to cross against, but I also know how dangerous it is.
You can have the best of engineering, but if people are not using them properly, then we're still going to have a lot of the same problems we've had historically.
We have multiple ways to reach the community and people that live here. Show and tell, and walk around, and talk with people, and get to the be it laundromats, grocery stores, transit stations, and provide people information.
More so than ever before, I believe that the police department has gotten into education and prevention. We try to get the message out.
EMS being involved in education is highly important. We see the aftermath. So if we can be out in the community and advocate for people before they become patients, we're doing a better job.
We look at this as a holistic approach. If we see a violation from pedestrian, we address it. And then we also address the violations that we see with car drivers.
These kinds of changes don't happen overnight. In fact, they involve a lot of engineering and a lot of work on the front end, but it's worth the effort.